The Child Center for tonight's non-conference games between the University of New Orleans Privateers and your Portland Pilots.
Busy day of primetime college hoops on the bluff. Now the Portland Pilot women just finished their rivalry game against Portland State. Now it's the fellas' turn. Pilots hosting the University of New Orleans, a rematch of last year's basketball classic tournament game right here at the Child Center. everybody, Ann Chester, I'm my broadcast partner, good friend. That's Jennifer Mountain, former great at Gonzaga, in the coaching ranks in the WCC as well. All right, the Pilots are thinking bounce back in a big way. Disappointing performance against North Dakota State. We didn't even recognize those guys. It's time for them to turn the page and get going.
Yeah, you know, talking to Coach Legs and just watching that performance the other night, they can't feel good about that second half especially. This is a great opportunity. This is a team that they saw last year in the basketball classic, but a team that's much better than their record, and this is a great opportunity for people to step up.
Jordan Johnson is the kind of guy for this New Orleans bunch. Transfer out of Denver, quick trigger from the three and an accurate one, too.
Yeah, great combo guard that really can shoot it at a high clip. 45% from the three-point line right now, averaging just under 16 points a game, leads the team in assists, and is a playmaker in transition. New Orleans needs a great effort from him tonight for them to have success on the road.
And if you are New Orleans, how are you going to get out of Dodge with the win?
Well, number one, you got to have inside point production. That's going to be key. And control the pace. They are really, really good in transition. They average 14 points right now as a team. Got to guard the three-point line just because Portland has so many weapons. And then rebounding on both ends of the floor are going to be crucial.
All right, let's talk Pilots. I know you have really been impressed with the improvement of Big V.
Man, the last 3 weeks, I really think he's coming into his own, making a ton of stride, playing with confidence. He's competing inside, aggressive to the rim. He's rebounding. He's an offensive threat and playing super strong. The Pilots need an inside presence from him from the beginning and doing a great job on the offensive and defensive glass.
What are the bounce back keys for the Pilots?
I really think they need to play with some urgency and some energy for 40 minutes. The live ball turnovers got to be important tonight because transition buckets, they love them. New Orleans loves them. Make them play in the half court, rebounding, and then the competition. Compete for 40 minutes.
All right. You ready for Pilot Hoops? Because we sure are. Pilots hosting New Orleans. Redemption. That's the game plan for the Portland Pilots. Lineups. Opening tip coming up next. Festive and holiday greetings to everyone. Beautiful job by the University of Portland to really decorate the campus. It just pops. Wally Pilot, part of the festivities. All right, we're at the Child Center. New Orleans in the house. J-Mo, you look at the starting lineup for the Privateers, and you like this Tyson Jackson fellow.
Yeah, he does a great job scoring 10 points a game for these guys. He is a presence inside, and that's an area right here where I think they can look to take advantage right from the get-go.
And for the Pilots, welcome back to the lineup and the starting lineup, Mike Meadows. He's missed a bunch of games with an injury.
He has, and he provides instant offense, a floor general. He just has a swagger about him. He's a scoring point guard, and they have missed him. I think he'll do a great job of getting them going in transition, and that'll be a big key tonight.
Portland Pilots coming in at 7-5, losing to North Dakota State the other night, 67-62. They just did not look like themselves. We'll see what kind of bounce back effort they can give tonight. While the Privateers come in at 2-5, losing to Louisiana Lafayette, one of the heartbreaking losses for New Orleans this year. They've had a few of those, losing in the final seconds. Don't look at their 2-5 record. They are much better than that.
You're absolutely right. I mean, many close games and just getting better and better as a collective group. They have four transfers in that have been, immediate impact guys, but he likes where they're at, and yeah, like you said, don't let that record fool you. They're a good ball club.
New Orleans winning the tip, coming in with the blue uniforms, hard to the rack, and really with some power. There's Jackson.
Right off the bat, I mean, mobile, not super huge inside, but just really active Nice job coming off the screen by T-Rob.
The answer is there. Moses Wood with the triple.
Great start for the Pilots. And if he can get going early, especially from the three-point land, they struggled the other night from the perimeter. Just a good sign for the Pilots.
Season low, 5 triples from beyond the arc the other night against North Dakota State. That's got to change.
That's too easy of a look right there. That's a free throw line jumper. Got to contest. Sholin coming off the stagger screen. Great look right there.
Completely different start for the Portland Pilots tonight. Rematch of last year's tournament game, the Basketball Classic. That was in March here at the Child Center. The Pilots defeating UNO 94-73. My goodness, what a start.
And again, just a little bit too easy of a look. Vucinic has got to get out and make him put it on the ground and just be a little bit more physical, I think, inside with Jackson.
So Jackson 6, the Pilots 6. What a start for Jackson. He gives you 10.6 points a pop. He's already got 6 all of New Orleans' points.
Well, ball out of bounds to New Orleans.
Privateer head coach Mark Schlesinger really likes the backcourt of this UNO club. Sackey, not known for his long ball shooting. They'll give him that.
Yeah, T-Rob doing a good job on the scout, just kind of backing off a little bit. Try to take away the inside game, make him prove it.
Good ball movement. 12 on the shot clock. Another triple for the Pilots. Sholin knocks down another one from distance, 9-6 Portland.
And Portland 3-4 from the three-point line. And again, you love to see that. They struggled to shoot from the perimeter the other night. Talking to Coach Legs, they've had a couple really good days in practice and really just needed to get back to the gym and start working on stuff.
5-for-19 against NDSU was the Portland Pilots the other night. All their field goal attempts and buckets coming from beyond the arc. Big V with the inside position, short on that shot. Nice board by Kirkland on the box out.
Well, they love to run in transition. This team, that's what their bread and butter is. They want to turn you over, and they want to go quick. Portland doing a nice job of taking it out in transition D. Good hustle.
To the floor goes Sholin. Well done. Those are the little things. And again, this looks like the Portland Pilot team we know and love, as opposed to the other night. We're just going to call that a one-off.
Yeah, they just did not look like themselves. They didn't play with urgency or energy tonight. Right off the bat, you can see diving on the floor, making things happen. I think they've done a nice job of sharing the basketball. I mean, you don't want to fall in love with a three-way, but if it's fallen, let it go, right?
Ha! Darius Washington checking in for the Privateers, as is Omarion Henry. So Schlesinger going to his bench. Winningest and longest tenured coach ever at New Orleans is Mark Schlesinger. 12th year, he's been fabulous.
He's done a terrific job. Multiple NCAA appearances.
8 on the shot clock. Mike Meadows. Doughty wants to lead the charge.
New Orleans doing a good job on the defensive boards. Good
ball
hands.
Up for grabs, yep. That started with Big V, able to knock it free.
I'll tell you, Lucianus has really done a nice job as of late. Very aggressive, scoring and defending, rebounding.
Plenty of time on the shot clock. Good patience by the Pilots. T-Rob putting the ball on the deck. Well, that's a great start for T-Rob, who now needs only 8 points for 1,000. So we are going to keep track of T-Rob. And, you know, he'll be the first to tell you, he just kind of stunk it up the other night.
Yeah, he was not happy with his performance. And I don't know if he was pressing or just, he just was not himself. None of them were. The second half, just not a team that we have seen. And that's a big bucket right there, almost 3 minutes with no field goal. Good response by New Orleans.
One possession lead for this Pilot bunch. T-Rob on the switch, good D by New Orleans. Most of the buckets coming from the perimeter for the Pilots. Big V would love it inside. Four on the shot clock for Mike. T-Rob's got to unload. It was short. He thought it was true. Again, one and done. Nice job on the defensive boards by New Orleans.
You're absolutely right. And, you know, I think right now they're kind of falling in love with that three-point shot. They've got to go inside, give him some touches, or get Christian Scholin or Moses on the block a little bit.
Here's Johnson.
Elevator screen. Didn't get through it.
Wow. So Sackey, with only his second triple of the season, it's 11-11.
Yeah, that's a scout thing. You know, every now and then that's going to happen. There's a good job of getting position down nice and low on the block.
Just where what you were looking for is, you know, Big V has that foul will go against Washington. Big V has been demanding that ball in the low block, and this time the angle was right. They found him. He drew the foul. We'll take a quick break. Great start to this game. UNO, Portland, 11 apiece. 14:30 left to go in the first half. T-Rob looking for a milestone. Apiece, 14:30 left to go in this opening half between the Portland Pilots and visiting New Orleans Privateers. There's a good look at Shante Leggins in his second year. Pied Piper, magician, whatever you want to call him. I know all of what I know is that lad can coach.
He's got a lot of energy, and he's got this program just turned around in a very short time.
Gorosito, Applewhite checking in for Portland. Another three ball for the Pilots. You know, they really want to get some mid-range looks, do the Portland Pilots, and they're settling right now for the three.
They really are. I mean, they're shooting 50% from the three-point line, but again, that opens up if you can get inside a little bit. Applewhite, nice offensive board right there. Oh, in and out.
Unlucky. Look at the Privateers, everybody hammering. As Joey St. Pierre, another sub coming in for the Pilots. Lowell, my goodness, legs going deep into his bench.
Well, he's got a lot of depth on that bench this season, and missed shot there by Applewhite. Again, another three-point shot. Yep. I just think right now it hasn't fallen for the last few possessions. Do something different, take them off the bounce. 8 of their 10 shots have been from the three-point line at this point.
Man.
Nice move.
Nice job by Henry to draw that foul. It's going to go against T-Rob, or excuse me, Scholin. His first, team's first.
Nice little spin move, and fortunate not to pick up an and one there.
Henry, freshman out of St. Louis. Had the 17 points against Denver. and has been really good for Schlesinger off the bench as Naduka checks in for the Pilots. Scholin will have a seat. So right now the Pilots with just one starter on the floor, and that's T-Rob.
Well, he likes his bench and the energy. You got Wanzi out there that really is fun to watch, can shoot the three, pushes the tempo. Here's a little 1-2-2 press, trying to make things happen. They love to turn people over. And right there, they get exactly what they want out of it, just going a little too fast.
It's been a couple of minutes plus for the Pilots since they found the bottom of the net. And UNO tip the cap, taking advantage with the 7-0 run. They lead by a deuce and have the ball. Henry decided to go against the three and now drag that pivot foot for the turnover.
Good defense by Naduka there, just cutting off the driving lane. Gets the walk.
13-11, UNO with the lead, 12:55 left to go in this first half. Pilots looking for a bounce back victory. Wyatt Lowell, triple, that's good. And again, a three-point attempt. This time it's true, Pilots with the lead.
Well, he can shoot the three. We saw that a couple games ago with six of them. Broke his finger in that game, or dislocated his finger and brought it, you know, he's feeling a lot better after it's been able to heal for a few days against Multnomah with six triples off the bench, just on fire. Becomes a hard matchup for an opponent. You got a big guy that's got a guard for the three-point line. That's a long closeout. Ooh. Block foul.
Yep. So Robertson picks up his first, team's second. Wyatt Lowell, well-traveled, Snow College, BYU, Utah Valley, and now University of Portland.
Oh, good
ball
hands.
Fake. Charge. Wow. And how about Wyatt Lowell playing it on both ends?
Well, that's what you need from your bench. You come in and contribute on both ends of the floor. Does a good job of just, you know, taking the contact. Smart defensive play. Hits a three prior to that. Good contribution in minutes.
Jackson picks up that foul. Lowell again. Good help defense by Lowell. Great block by Gorosito and sticking with it, but short on that shot is Murphy Jr. Here comes Portland. They've got numbers. T-Rob all the way to the cup, you bet. He needs eight, maybe six now.
And a nice take and then a miscommunication right there and a turnover by New Orleans. Portland will get the ball right at half court.
Look at T-Rob erasing the bitter taste in his mouth from the other night. Aggressive to the hole. They want buckets at the cup. They got one there. Cavaliers have been turning it over in the middle of a drought. And Portland taking advantage, J-Mo, 16-13, Pilots with the lead, 11:49 left to go in the first half.
Yeah, 4 of 6 from the three-point line. I think T-Rob doing a nice job of getting to the cup, like you said, mixing it up so they're not just shooting from the three. But, you know, New Orleans, 3 turnovers in the last 90 seconds and no field goals in 3 minutes. However, bright spot, they're out-rebounding Portland 10-4 right now in this half.
Keep your eye on that rebounding tally, that's for sure. Here's Gorosito, the freshman. Dynamic player out of Argentina.
Yeah, he's fun to watch. No fear.
Boy, and coming off the pick, the defender goes underneath the pick and Gorosito hits.
You cannot go under an on ball or a screen on this guy.
Another triple for the Pilots. Good help defense, Gorosito.
Good hands.
And Jack Perry with the good hands, he's come in off the bench. So smart, so heady, the veteran just gets in the way.
Well, he's in the right spot most of the time. Portland on an 8-0 run in this last minute.
Wow.
Nice.
Another turnover by UNO. Gorosito, catch, shoot, you bet!
And he is not afraid to pull the three in transition. 6 points.
11-0 Pilot run, the lead 22-13. My goodness.
And it's turnovers right now. 4 turnovers in the last 2 minutes.
Kirkland stops the bleeding.
And this is a team that likes to turn you over. Getting a taste of its own medicine a little bit.
Some of the privateer turnovers, though, are just sloppy.
Yep.
Perry on the weave. Here's Gorosito. Extra pass.
Good swing.
Applewhite, 7 on the shot clock, and the foul's going to go against New Orleans. Wilson Rouse with his first.
You can take a look right here. Just, again, he has no fear of shooting the basketball coming off that on ball. Nice little pull, and then in transition. On balance, nice looking shot.
Scoreless against North Dakota State, so that's got to feel good to Gorosito. Applewhite, the transfer out of Mississippi State. 80% free throw shooter is Alvin.
Well, he just provides such athleticism. Can get to the rim, he's a lefty, he can shoot the three, rebounds hard.
And because he's so aggressive, he gets to the line a lot, only makes 1 of 2 there. But he's that guy that really does force the issue and get to the hole.
You're right. And he's been a great bright spot coming off the bench for these guys.
Jackson misses. So hot to start this game.
Again, rebounds right here are the big factor.
10 on the shot clock for Sackey.
11-4, they lead in the rebound category.
And Sackey, who averages 2 points a game, they're gonna give him that shot. They're gonna lay off Sackey, will the Pilot defenders. No starters on the floor right now for the Pilots, and they still lead 23-15 thanks to a 12-2 run. Roll not there, good board by Kirkland.
Well, this lineup's giving them a nice spark. You know, you love to see the depth like we talked about last year. You know, they're playing 6 guys most of the time, and New Orleans, 1 of their last 8 from the field right now.
So Lowell picks up that foul, his first, team's third.
Portland doing a nice job defensively of making them take tough shots, scout shots, giving up, you know, what they need personnel-wise, but just not doing a great job on the boards right now.
So T-Rob and Big V back in. Nice shifts for Lowell and Naduka. 23-15, 9:15 left to go in this first half. Good hands inside, still short with that shot as Jackson. One and done, here comes Gorosito.
Good rebound by Applewhite.
Unlucky there as Gorosito Wanze stepping on the baseline.
I like his aggressiveness. Yeah, you can see it right there. I think the ball actually went out of bounds, but I like his aggressiveness. Sometimes he goes a little too quick. Only the second turnover for Portland right now, so you gotta be pretty happy. Because again, New Orleans, that's what they try to do, is they try to speed you up and turn you over.
...23-15.
Mike Meadows back in the game.
Nice shift for Gorosito, that's for sure.
Yes.
Head fake, Wilson Rouse.
Nice take.
I'll say.
Nice little floater.
When UNO lost Derek St. Hilaire and Troy Green, all conference guys, to graduation, and, you know, G League kind of guys, as Perry drills the three, getting Wilson Rouse was huge for UNO.
Yeah, he has fit into their system. And Portland, 7 of 13 with that three from Jack Perry. You know, the thing about Perry, he never forces the issue. He's in the right spot. He's a coach on the floor, takes a shot when he should. And that's a big hit right there for him.
You know, when Mike goes down with that injury and misses all those games, Jack just seamlessly heads into the starting role and doesn't miss a beat. Good look inside, Big V, and one! T-Rob finds a Big V, does the damage inside.
That was a great vision for where I was. I saw him pinned, did a great job. T-Rob finding him inside and a great finish with the body contact.
Jackson picks up his second, team's fourth.
This is what I love about Vucinic. I mean, you compare him now to last year at this time. He doesn't make that shot. This year, takes the contacts and finishes.
35 field goals for Big V this year is already more than last year's total. That's the surge of Big V. Applewhite, you bet! Oh, what a first half for the Pilots, erasing the bad memory from the other night against North Dakota State. 8 triples now for the Pilots.
And that's off an Applewhite offensive board right there. They're on an 8-0 run in the last 25 seconds and just red hot from the three-point line.
A couple of huge runs in this second half for the Portland Pilots. 31-17, Portland with the lead, and UNO looking for answers. Coach talks about depth. How about the bench of the Portland Pilots tonight?
16 points right now in the half. Applewhite, you see there with that three, knocks it down. And doing a great job. You know, you look at the bench and talking to Coach Legs the other day, you know, he's talked about the fact that he maybe should have stuck with some of his bench players a little bit longer, giving him an opportunity here with different lineups with Mike Meadows back in.
We're going to stop play for a second. Over the last 4.5 minutes or so, a 20-4 Portland Pilot run. 31-17 is what the scoreboard tells you. You know, and it wasn't that long ago when it was 11 apiece, J-Mo.
You're absolutely right. I mean, seven turnovers led to 13 points for Portland, which is huge. And really just defensively doing a job themselves, contesting. Again, the only category that we're really struggling in right now is on the boards, and it's 13-7 with them four offensive boards in the half.
T-Rob playing some pretty good defense inside, and Washington throws up the wild shot. T-Rob hustles down and gets the three. Three points is all T-Rob needs for 1,000. 3 points. That's coming, folks.
There's a steal right there. Great hands. They have numbers.
Catch. Another pass. Sholin. T-Rob.
Thought that might be the one.
Very unselfish passing. There were three different three-point looks in that possession.
And Portland on 11-0 run in the last minute, 15 seconds. And again, making them take, turnover. And right back over to Portland.
Legs can't believe that. Cannot believe that.
I don't think the referee could see it, the angle that he was at. Unfortunate, but the thing that I love that Portland's doing is they're making them take tough, contested shots.
Yikes.
Each time down.
Okay, let's see.
There's the turnover, but they bring it right back.
Oh, goodness.
He just loses it out of his hands.
Sure. Okay, a break for UNO. Kirkland puts an elbow into the chops of Sholin, draws the foul as well. So Sholin picks up number two, team's fourth.
And he got hit hard in the
nose.
Yeah,
he did. So a warning given to Legs and the pilot bench, specifically Legs.
Yeah, not happy about that call previous and just the physical contact right there.
UNO only makes six triples a game. So you're going to dare somebody to really start heating it up from beyond the arc. And on cue, Jordan Johnson, who leads this club in terms of makes, drills it. The answer comes from Moses Wood. 10th triple for the Pilots. Already their season high, 17 against Multnomah.
Well, I mean, and they're taking what they're giving them. Great look by Sholin, finding Wood. Ball goes inside in transition, kicks it back out. Good look for Wood.
So Applewhite picks up that foul, his first, team's fifth. And here's Jordan Johnson, the transfer out of Denver. Top of the Southland Conference in multiple categories. Versatile player. Gives you 16 points a game that leads the Privateers.
Shooting almost 46 from the three-point line.
Yep.
And you talked about the fact they don't have a ton of shooters, but he's one guy that can really,
that's the guy,
really heat it up.
Yep.
You take it.
37-20, 6:15 left. Privateers starting to feel it a little bit offensively.
Oh, good little spin move right there.
And the step back. Sholin loses it. Here comes Wilson Rouse.
Well, you can see that Portland's not sending a lot of guys to the offensive glass. Worried about New Orleans' transition game because, again, that's their bread and butter.
So we'll go the other way. We'll see if the Privateers in the next 550 can get within 10.
Well, I think this is a crucial time in the game here. You've got to, in the last 5.5 minutes here, close this gap going into halftime, giving yourself a chance. You let Portland continue on this run, you're going to have a hard time winning this ball game. UNO has been involved in so many close games. Fumbled, found, and hit. I mean, T-Rob almost lost it. Instead goes to Wood. He's got 9 on the triple.
Well, Portland doing a great job. Every time that ball goes inside, they're locating a shooter on the perimeter, kicking it out and getting a good look.
Good defense by Meadows, cutting off Wilson Rouse. 14 on the shot clock, switching hands is Johnson. Cooper doesn't take a lot of threes. Now he's 2 for 3 from beyond the arc on the season.
Well, I like what Portland has done on Johnson, just putting somebody long on him. The length of Moses Wood, I think, has kind of taken his three-point shooting ability away. And there's another answer from the three-point line by Scholin.
Yeah, and Washington just kind of shrugs, but coming off that pick hard, wide open, and a great look for Scholin. 9 for Scholin.
And Portland's got 12 three-point shots in the first half with 4.5 to go.
Perry picks up his first, team's 6th. Henry back onto the floor for UNO, Sackey as well. 5 of New Orleans' 7 games have been decided by 7 points or less. Tonight, they're going to have to really work hard to get close to see if they can win one of those tight ball games. Nothing on that high pick. Perry with 15 on the shot clock. Here's Mike.
Good board.
Big V, yeah, there's the follow.
You know what I love about that is he did not put the ball back on the ground off the offensive board, just went straight back up. That's exactly what they need from the big guy.
You love the out board and the put back.
Yep.
Great hands by Meadows. Mike doesn't have numbers. Let's see what he does. Oops. Shot clock, possession arrow belonging to UNO.
Well, let's hope that Meadows is okay here.
Yeah.
You know, he's been dealing with a groin injury, and he went spread on that pretty quick.
Boy, that was an awkward land for Mike walking off the floor. Let's just hope he's okay. 45-25, what a first half for the Portland Pilots. Everything going right. Look at Big V using the hops and finishing.
25 Portland, all over New Orleans. 3:37 left to go in this first half. J-Mo, I don't even know where to start in terms of the numbers or trends that jump out at us.
Oh my gosh, 60% from the three-point line, 12 of 20, and they're good looks. The inside out, fast break, at fast break points, 11-0. And they have 16 points off the New Orleans 10 turnovers. Just doing a terrific job offensively. And quite frankly, making them take contested jumpers.
Yep.
Personnel, scout-wise, they've done a nice job. And just a great collective effort. They have 12 assists on their 16 field goals in this first half. Just tremendous.
You know, last year when these two teams met, the Pilots had 9 of their 16 triples in the first half. Oh, they're really putting the hurt on New Orleans beyond the arc tonight.
Well, and like I said, I mean, quality looks. It's not like they're forcing it at all.
Legs going to his bench again. You want to close this first half out with a lot of emphasis and determination if you're the Pilots, not giving New Orleans any thought of, hey, we're still in this thing.
Yeah, no, this is where you put the pedal to the metal and even really get after it. And there's another one right there. I mean, they're just getting quality looks from the three-point line. And when you have multiple guys that can shoot the three the way the Pilots do, he's 4 of 4 from the three-point line for 12 points in this first half.
And on that inbound play, no one closed on Wood. And he knew the second that he shot it, he was going to go for it. And there's Jordan Johnson, best free throw, or excuse me, three-point shooter for UNO. So he's got a chance for a four-point play.
Yeah, Wanzi just a little too aggressive right there.
Yep.
That's inexperience. Coach Legg not happy with that foul. Well, and you like to see Mike Meadows back in
yes.
the game. I was a little worried on that last play at the other end just with that groin injury, but he seems to be just fine.
That's Jordan Johnson.
Good sign for the Pilots.
Yeah, it is. We all kind of held our collective breaths.
Mm-hmm.
After the hot start by Jackson for UNO, it's been Johnson trying to carry the load. Turnover, well played, Sackey. Wheeling, dealing.
Whoa.
Short on that shot, another offensive board. This time it's Cooper.
Well, doing a nice job again on the glass. Aggressive, that's their fifth offensive board in the half.
Yep. Lowell's second foul, team's eighth. So here's Cooper, the transfer out of Bluefield State.
They have four transfers that have come in and made an immediate impact.
So Johnson out of the University of Denver, one of those. And there's a good look at Cooper, again from Bluefield State.
Well, and Wilson Rouse, too, you know,
he's
a WCC guy from Pacific that transferred and has really fit into what they're trying to do.
I really liked his game with Pacific over the course of his career. He was really a steady player for them and a great addition for UNO.
Yeah, a little too deep right there. That's probably the first shot that they, ill-advised shot, I'd say, from the three-point line.
And the way the Pilots have been shooting, you can live with that.
Yeah, I mean, that's his first miss of the game, so.
You can live with that.
Yep.
48-29. Johnson short on that shot.
Good rebound.
Here's Wood. Takes the contact. Look for the and one, but he'll go to the line for a pair.
Well, you just see the versatility of Moses Wood. He's been just great from the three-point line, obviously, all night long, but then takes it off the bounce, creates the contact, and almost gets an and one.
Henry with the foul, his first.
Little in-and-out dribble, gets to the paint.
Wood, an 87% free throw shooter. Had 13-8 against North Dakota State in that losing effort, but 3 for 11 field goal.
Yeah, just again, him and T-Rob, you know, just did not shoot the ball well the other night.
They were a combined 6-for-29 against North Dakota State, a combined 1-for-9 beyond the arc. And for T-Rob not to be in double figures, so he settled for 9. You got to go back to last year, don't you?
27 straight, I believe.
You got to go back to January 17th of last year when he had 7 against LMU, to be exact. T-Rob not getting double figures is headlines.
Yep.
Applewhite back in, Perry out. And again, T-Rob sitting on a milestone moment tonight. Only needs 3 to hit 1,000.
Well, just a special player, obviously. He can score the ball, but he does so many other things. Whoa. Applewhite got caught in the air there. Good defense.
Floater. Tough shot by Wilson Rouse.
Well, you see how fast they run, want to go here in a pace. That's when they're best. It's not in the half court, it's in the open court.
You bet. If they can put a little run together without taking a lot of time off the clock.
Good hustle.
Ball up for grabs. Big V sticking with it. So the officials say that Wilson Rouse was able to call timeout. It didn't look like anyone really had possession.
So, no, I think it's actually going to be Portland's ball.
Okay.
Underneath on the baseline. But I agree. I thought they had said that he had called timeout. Wilson Rouse had called timeout, but I didn't think he had possession of the basketball.
Huh. Well.
But to your point, right before that happened, is you're right. You do not want to get New Orleans in quick transition so that they can make a little run here in this last minute. That's where they're really, really good, is getting out and going.
Wilson Rouse showed us that.
Yeah, and it is going to be Portland ball. 9 seconds on the shot clock.
Buck 5 left to go in the half.
Well, that works out in their favor with a kick ball. Goes back to 20 on the shot clock.
Sure does. T-Rab looking for a cutter. Big V, single coverage, deep. Follow, you bet.
Good follow. 6 points right now on the night. Again, I love his aggressiveness. Just adding another element for Portland inside.
Legs really challenged Big V to get stronger, to get in that weight room.
Yeah, he put on 30 pounds of muscle over the summer. And it is paying off. Great defense by T-Rob to pick up the offensive foul.
Legg says that T-Rob is one of the best guys in the league taking charges. You know, you don't coach that necessarily. This is a guy that just makes the effort. And speaking of, here's Big V.
Yeah, just a great second effort right there and a putback. T-Rob, 7.7 assists, and obviously a great defensive possession right there. Heads up play.
T-Rob, one of 2 guys in Division I play to average 15 points, 6 boards, and 6 assists. Think about that now.
Yeah, it's a pretty good line.
Dang. All right. 10 on the shot clock for T-Rob.
Nice.
There's the
door.
Cut! Oh, baby! Throwing it down is Wood. The veterans reading each other perfectly. Moe's got 16. Woo! Oh, the Child Center is buzzing after that last throwdown. Wood with a sensational first half, 16 points. And what a dish by Robertson, his 8th helper of the night, resulting in that flush.
Just a great offensive possession, or excuse me, performance by the Pilots. Bounce back effort.
54-31, Pilots at the half.
I love the fact that higher education can be transformative. It can change someone's trajectory of their life. So it's my hope that the University of Portland, we are the transformative Catholic university in the West Coast. I was born and raised in the great state of New Jersey. I'm the youngest person in my family. I have some amazing parents who have sacrificed a lot to provide an education for me and my brother. You know, we grew up knowing you're going to get your education, you're going to go to church, and anything is possible as you go forward in your life. My name is Rob Kelly, and I am the president of the University of Portland.
We were simply thrilled when Dr. Kelly accepted the opportunity to come to the University of Portland. We spent hours, weeks, months discerning this important decision, and he was exactly what this university needs moving forward.
Nice to see you.
I think you've already seen that on campus already. Dr. Kelly's everywhere. He's ubiquitous. He's energetic. I think he's a tremendous role model. His experience in higher education at this university and other universities will serve him so very well. There's no one more prepared to lead this university into its next great chapter here on the Bluff.
One. This is my first day with lots of students on campus in a physical format. The students are back, and this is the beginning of it. It's like Christmas morning.
Clearly a person that was able to build connections and relationships with people. His prior experiences, it was very intentional that Rob was preparing himself to one day hopefully have the opportunity to lead a Catholic university, and grateful that he chose us as much as we chose him.
I've been so blessed to know him for over 24 years, and one of the very first conversations we had, we found out we both loved higher ed, and he talked about, I want to be a college president one day. And it really struck me because my father was a college president, and so I saw a lot of similarities in somebody that I, you know, greatly admire and love more than anything. He is like the cheerleader for our family.
My children, Alex and Addison, first they ground me completely. They give all of this work that I'm doing and everything meaning.
To be such a collaborator, communicator, and somebody that really deeply believes in justice, it seemed like those were the things that he just naturally is.
I have been extremely blessed to have different people in my life. People like Sister Frances, who is my fourth grade school teacher. I remember those little lessons that she taught us, and I bring that with me into the work that I do now.
Welcome to all of you.
My message to students would be that they're loved. Want to walk with them and accompany them as they go off and do amazing things in the world. And we're always going to be there. It's about community, and we're going to help them to get connected as we go forward in life.
Welcome home, and go Pilots.
Dr. Kelly, on behalf of the entire Board of Regents, we are thrilled that you are finally here on the Bluff.
Dr. Kelly and his family, so grateful that you've become a part of the University of Portland. Can't wait to see all the fantastic things that we can accomplish.
Welcome Dr. Kelly to Villa Maria Hall.
Welcome Dr. Kelly to the University of Portland.
We're so proud of you and wish you the best of luck at the University of Portland.
Congrats that I'm becoming president. I'm really proud of you.
Every day, remember where your strength lies. God and heaven are below our feet and above our heads, and so always look up and remember that you are loved and you can do this. Congratulations.
Congratulations, President Kelly. God bless you.
24-31. The Pilots putting the hurt on New Orleans here at the Child Center. Impressive first half for the Pilots, without a doubt.
Well, just offensively, I mean, just a tremendous job of scoring the basketball. 13 of 22 from the three-point line for almost 60%. And quality looks, like we talked about. I mean, they had open looks on balance. Moses Wood, 16 first half points, 4 of 5 from the three-point line. And they did a great job of just sharing the basketball.
Those 13 triples by the Pilots in a first half, that's a program record for first half makes from beyond the arc. And T-Rob ever closer to the milestone of 1,000 career points.
Yeah, 7 points in the half. He's just 3 away. But more importantly, 8 assists, 2 rebounds. He's doing a little bit of everything. Just does a great job defensively, picking up charges. Smart offensive player, obviously. And like I said, 8 assists on the half. That's probably a better stat than his scoring ability right now.
Because you know that 1,000 mile marker is coming, because we know that guy can shoot. But I love the helpers, I love the assists from T-Rob. Look at him, so strong, so smart.
Yeah, and every time that ball went inside, a nice little kick out for threes. And again, just a great job of scoring from the three-point line.
And there's one of Moses Wood's 4 triples. All right, numbers. If you're a Pilot fan, you're gonna love these.
You really are. I mean, you look at the shooting percentage. Rebounds, you see that they're tied. Most of that half, they struggled. The last 5 minutes, doing a great job. Assists right there, 14 on 19 field goals, and only 5 turnovers. And the 11 turnovers that they caused ended up in 18 points for the Pilots in this first half.
And you just keep peeling away that stat sheet, and you keep looking at some numbers that, again, tell the story.
Look at the points in the paint, 12-6. Fast break points. I talked about New Orleans. That's their bread and butter. And right now, they're getting killed 11-2. And then bench points. I think the bench did a great job tonight. And again, it's just that depth that Portland has this year that's going to be great for them down the road.
Boy, has Portland, quote unquote, bounced back from that other night.
I'll tell you, gut check, I think. They had a couple great practices, Coach Legg said. And, you know, just shows the character of this group. They did not play well the other night, and a great response. Now they got to put two halves together. You can't just be satisfied with where you are in this half. You got to have another complete half to complete the game.
But man, you got to feel good about the first half performance against a quality New Orleans club. 54-31, second half just around the corner. The Portland Pilots looking to put pedal to the metal, baby. first half performance by the Pilots to remember. 54-31, Portland leading the visiting Privateers from New Orleans. And to your point, J-Mo, with this Pilot depth, guys coveting minutes and opportunities to play, I don't expect any kind of letup.
No, and this is where you really make the next jump. The second half, you got to come in and this first few minutes, just keep it to the metal. Take it right at them. No fear. You don't want to get sloppy. You got to play solid basketball on both ends of the floor.
So second half underway. Pilots with the hefty 54-31 lead.
Oh!
Oh! Scholin had to go up and over. Another assist for T-Rob. Scholin in. Oh, my goodness. Double figures, and that was something else. What a finish by Christian.
I mean, he got up, and then all of a sudden, another little level there. Just a great move. Great pass.
I mean, Christian cocks it back and has to go up and over Simeon Kirkland for the flush.
Well, I'm not sure if we have, they're looking for maybe upgrading this foul to a flagrant.
Official review.
And that's what they're doing. They're going to take a look at a potential upgrade on this foul. Again, anything above the head these days is almost an immediate upgrade.
So T-Rob's ninth assist moments ago results in Scholin's massive, massive throwdown. You know, when you look at Christian Scholin, and we've seen him be kind of a spurts guy. You know, the first three of the season, Christian averages 16 points a pop. Next four, he comes down to earth a bit, averages 8. Last five, going into this game, averaging 14, and he's at 11 right now.
Well, he has the ability, like you said, a spurt guy, where all of a sudden, you know, he can explode. We saw it last year, that San Francisco game, something switched.
That's what it was.
And, man, I mean, he's such an athlete, too. Like, you just don't see it sometimes, that all of a sudden, like that play right there, that is an athletic big-time dunk. And he can shoot it. He can put it on the ground. He's got an NBA body. I mean, he just does some things, you know, that all of a sudden you go, whoa, where'd that come from? And like you said, you just like to, you know, trying to keep it more level so you don't have the spurts consistency. But last five games, like you said, doing a great job.
So, again, looking at the monitor, let's see what we've got here. So you see the elbow from Jackson to the face of Big V.
Oh. That's just inadvertent contact. That's just a basketball play. I don't, they are going to upgrade it, I think.
Well, one of the officials coming over and whispering to you an upgrade, and it looks like that's exactly what's going to happen.
Yep, it turned to a flagrant one, so they'll get two shots here in the ball.
The foul on Tyson Jackson was a flagrant foul.
I don't know. That was, I didn't see a whole lot of contact on that. Maybe just a bad angle.
The elbow extended a little bit as Vucinic airballs the first one. Big V doesn't shoot a lot of free throws. That's his 13th free throw attempt of the season. That one looks pretty sweet.
That's a good response right there.
Ball's out of bounds to the Pilots.
So 7 points now for Big V. That's right at his seasonal average. He's a 71% field goal shooter, is Vucinic. Now, he doesn't shoot a whole lot, but man, when he does.
Well, that's what you want. You want him to take the right kind of shot, and that's what he's doing. Not forcing it, putbacks, making a move on the block.
Dumping it, high low, layup.
Nice.
Great look from Scholin inside to Big V.
Just a great pass from Scholin. And a good finish.
The route continues for the Pilots.
Yeah, New Orleans just, to me, doesn't have the fight right now. Not a lot of energy. That's a nice little move right there, however.
The only bad news of this game is at the end, end of the bench sits Mike Meadows in a warm-up jacket. Remember when he landed awkwardly in that first half, coming off of a long stretch where he didn't play because of the groin injury, and we're not going to suppose anything, but I'm not sure he plays again tonight.
Well, it's actually probably smart because they don't need
Correct.
Him. So why aggravate anything? He came back and looked fine. So I would say this is probably just more of a precautionary, just sit him out. There's no reason to risk it, you know, up 26.
Mike in that starting lineup for the first time since Kent State. Wilson Rouse lands awkwardly. He'll go to the line.
That's a nice little take. Yeah, help wasn't there. Back to the ball there. Got to open up so you can see it and step over and help. Just a little bit late.
Wilson Rouse, the transfer from Pacific, averages 13 points a game. Really loving his role for New Orleans. Good player at Pacific, started the 15 games last year and gave that club 5 points a pop, but he's in double figures consistently and a very good rebounding guard.
Yeah, really scrappy, athletic, quick. Here's that pressure.
6-5 now for Wilson Rouse. Privateers need some stops. Dumping it. What an assist. Double figure assist. Another dunk. This time Big V. T-Rob with his 10th helper. Man, what a game he's having.
And just in the exact place for Vucinic to catch that and finish. Great vision.
T-Rob's career assist high is 12. He had that earlier this season against Multnomah. He's sitting on 10 right now. Check this out to the lead hand.
Perfect pass.
Perfect pass. My goodness. And again, he only needs 3 points, does T-Rob, for 1,000. That guy is worth the price of admission. Mm-hmm. Looks like Applewhite with the trip. That'll be his second, team's second.
It's getting kind of physical on both ends of the floor here. Officials doing a nice job of just blowing the whistle a little bit, just to get it under control so it doesn't get too chippy. Good trap.
You better love that in the corner. Wilson Rouse, how clever is that? My goodness, what a play by Caleb.
That's a great job of staying with it.
Applewhite, ooh, good strip. I think Washington might have gotten banged up on that play. Yes.
You see him in that trap. He gets out of it. Ball is loose, falling down.
Oh.
Grace, little flip back. Great job of staying with it.
So Applewhite whistled for that foul, his third. You know, and with all the sensational buckets that we've seen on Portland's side, that last flip and bucket by the Privateers, thanks to Wilson Rouse, is right up there top five for me.
It was really nice.
That was a turnover waiting to happen, and Caleb made magic happen.
Great 61-37. Job of staying with the play.
Looking for the high-low, nothing there. Long ball, Cooper doesn't hit many of those. Came into this game 1-for-2 from beyond the arc. He's got 6 points.
Well, sometimes that happens. You know, scout-wise, and all of a sudden somebody gets hot.
Wilson Rouse with his second personal. So to the free throw line is Robertson, one of the best free throw shooters in the country. Will it be a little anticlimactic if he gets to 1,000 via the free throw?
Well, maybe.
You know, he's pretty darn much a lock at the free throw line. Leads this club with makes and takes in terms of the charity tosses.
Tyler.
Ooh. Oh. And jinxed him.
Yeah.
All right, needs 2 points. Come on, T-Rob, give us the old-fashioned bucket or a three ball. Ball falls into the hands of Big V. He's got the 6 boards to go with 11 points. J-Mo, what was it like for you when you hit 1,000 and then another 400? But you played at Gonzaga at the highest level. But what was that like for you?
I honestly don't remember.
Come on.
I really don't.
I remember when I hit 50 for my career. That was it.
That was a long time ago.
Ball's going to stay with the Pilots as the foul's going to go against Wilson Rouse. His third, team's third. Okay, Naduka into the Pilot lineup. Jennifer Mountain, one of the all-time greats at Gonzaga, some 1,400 career points, and she's telling me she doesn't remember 1,000. I don't believe it for a minute.
I don't.
Nah, I don't believe it. Applewhite.
Again, this game's getting really physical.
Yeah, it really is. Applewhite got hammered, and guys need to be real aware of keeping their cool out there.
I mean, there's only been 3.5 minutes off the clock. 7 fouls between the two teams.
Murphy Jr. first, team's fourth. Applewhite to the line, and again, what Legs really likes about this guy, lots of things, but when he gets to the line, he's very productive in terms of finishing those free throws.
And does a great job of getting to the line just because of his handles and athleticism. You got to respect his three, and then he can get by you.
Transfer from Mississippi State. Injured most of last season. And Applewhite has done a great job off the bench for the Pilots.
Right now, Portland's bench, 18 points in the ball game. And that's certainly a positive note for the Pilots.
Lowell back on the floor for the Pilots as well. When Legs can go deep into his bench like this and not play his starters 35, 36 minutes, how important is that?
Well, it's going to be huge, especially down the stretch. Just keeping their legs fresh. Injuries, the more minutes, the higher chance of an injury. So that's a nice move. And that's his first basket, Jackson's first basket, since the 18:39 mark in the first half.
Remember, he was basically scoring basket after basket. He had the first 6 points for New Orleans and then went quiet. And there it is, T-Rob. Welcome to the 1,000 point club. Well done.
I'm glad that we got to see it.
Me too. And I'm glad it came on a bucket and not a free throw. Just saying. Tyler Robertson following Shantae Leggins from Eastern Washington to the Bluff and has been sensational. 1,000 points. Come on, T-Rob, atta baby. Yeah, you will never forget that. J-Mo, come on now. T-Rob, 1,000 points. How does that feel, big fella? I think he knew it, too. He pointed up.
Yeah.
And pointed to the stands, and this is a special moment, J-Mo. You don't remember yours, but by gosh.
He's going to remember his.
You know it.
And I will remember his.
Double-double for T-Rob. 10 points, 10 assists. You know, earlier this season, he had that triple-double against Multnomah with 12, 10, and 12. Just another typical T-Rob performance. I'm going to remember this, too, J-Mo. He's a special, special guy.
He really is, and he just does so much for this squad. And like you said, follows, you know, legs from Eastern and has just been a tremendous asset to this program, the culture overall.
You know, when legs came here, Mike Meadows, Jack Perry, Tyler Robertson follows legs here, and what a difference it was to have those three with Coach Legs to right the ship.
Well, you know, you got three guys that know exactly what you want, what you're about, and it just makes the buy-in a little bit easier, I would say. Not that it's easy, but when you have somebody on the floor that's just like your coach, that makes a big difference, and those guys, they're great ambassadors for him.
Resulting last year in the Pilots' best season since 2010. T-Rob and one! Keep it coming, big fella! Cooper got him. T-Rob, head of the line for a chance to complete the three-point play.
Well, the one thing that I've been really pleased with, you know, in the first 5 minutes here is they had did such a tremendous job of shooting the three. They're scoring in other ways. They're going to the rim. They're getting to the free throw line. You know, Vucinic did a nice job of baskets inside, and just shows the versatility of the squad. They only have one three-point shot in this half compared
That's
to
amazing.
Yeah.
Oh. You love the idea. Moses is saying, just missed that one.
It's a little too high. Yeah, he almost had it.
So the first half, the Pilots 13 for 22 from beyond the arc, and now they're just going inside, getting high percentage stuff, some and ones. Alden Applewhite, another assist, T-Rob.
Great vision in transition.
T-Rob, 11 assists, one off of tying his career high. And safe into home is T-Rob.
Safe into home.
Cooper picks up his second, team sixth. It was just a funky night watching the Pilots play like they did against North Dakota State. It just wasn't this team, none of them. And for them to, you know, put that one in the rearview mirror and come back with the kind of performance that they've shown us, pretty impressive.
Really impressive. And again, it shows the character of this squad. You know, they've been on a 7-0 run in the last minute and a half, three of their last three field goals, and they're getting layups. You know, they're not stopping. They're getting quality shots. And, you know, obviously this guy here leading the pack, he keeps it up. He could have a triple-double.
Yep. 20-4 run in that first half set the tone. Another foul is going to go against New Orleans.
Well, I think the officials doing a nice job because it has gotten pretty physical, so they're really trying to tighten it up a little bit. But, I mean, we have 14, 18 left in this half and
oh my
in
goodness.
The bonus. That was almost a travel on the board.
The Pilots shot 44 free throws earlier this season against Portland State. Good D inside. Nice finish and follow.
Good D by Vucinic. Not picking up a foul. Staying high and strong. But a good follow.
Jackson now with 10 points. Unlucky there. And here comes UNO. 13:40 left to go in this game. A game comfortably in favor of the Pilots. Sackey.
Well, again, you want to stay solid. You don't want to let up the stuff, you know, the, oh. Offensive foul.
So Robertson is whistled for his second, team's fifth. Perry, Ugoracito, Sholin back on the floor for the Pilots. He was 11-11 with about 14 and a half minutes left to go in the first half. Anybody's game. And then the Pilots
exploded.
Man, did they ever. All the heartbreaking losses by New Orleans heading into this game. Well, this is just a outright drubbing. Perry can't get it down. Vucinic tries to keep it alive. Instead, here comes UNO.
Good hands by Gorzito.
Monse will go the other way. Wyatt, great ball fake. Basket didn't want it.
Great ball fake.
15 turnovers really hurting the privateer cause. Jackson, short.
Portland's gonna use clock a little bit here and get a quality shot.
More good hands by Henry. Sackey.
Again, you don't want to get sloppy and start turning the basketball over. You want quality possessions. And there's a great defensive effort by Gorzito picking up the offensive foul.
He anticipated where Sackey was going to go, so Sackey picks up that foul. His first, team's eighth. Good D by the youngster. Murphy Jr. back onto the floor for UNO, and Johnson will have a seat. Frustrating night for the Privateers.
Yeah, just have not gotten anything going offensively. Loved transition, haven't turned him over.
Lowell waiting for the cutter, picks up that dribble, he's gotta find some help. Gorosito now with 10 on the shot clock. Doesn't take the pick, keeps the dribble alive. The flip, the shot, whoa! Everybody wondering what's gonna happen now.
Exactly. Yep. I mean, it was a block shot, obviously, but there's 1 second on the clock.
Wow, all right, we're gonna take a quick timeout. 71-46. The Pilots running away with this one. Lots of playing time for lots of guys, and it has been a dominant performance by the Pilots at this point, almost midway through the second half. So let's take a look at this play, J-Mo, that have the official has the officials talking.
Well, you see the block shot, but he follows through and hits him. And then continues to fall. To me, that's a foul on New Orleans.
So you love the closeout. The effort was great, but then he goes through the play and into the body. All right, J-Mo, the officials explaining to you what they say.
Well, we have a shooting foul, and he will go to the free throw line and shoot three on the three-point shot, but then we also have a dead ball foul where New Orleans will shoot at the other end.
Okay.
I think what they're calling on Christian is he kind of grabbed him as he went down. I don't know if you saw that in that replay.
Did not. I saw that Cholin got popped pretty good.
Unsportsmanlike conduct on Cortland number 12, Christian Cholin.
So Cholin will shoot free throws, but he's also whistled for the flagrant.
Yeah, he kind of hooked him going down, but I mean, kind of a natural reaction of, you know, trying to not fall. So he's going to shoot three, and then they'll go to the other end and shoot two free throws.
Doughty was the one that got Cholin. Rims out the second. I think, J-Mo, I came into this game kind of under the impression I was going to learn a lot about the Portland Pilots tonight in terms of what they were going to bring to the court after that disappointing performance against North Dakota State. Not that it's a bad loss to that really quality Bison team, but the way they lost.
You're absolutely right. The way they lost, it was not a typical Portland Pilot effort. I don't think anybody that watched that game would have ever expected it, number one, because I haven't seen it in Legs' tenure here. And talking with him and even some of the players, they were just so unhappy with their performance. And what a great job. There's still 11 and a half minutes left to go in this game, but so far, a much better effort.
72-48, 11:33 left to go in this second half. A game dominated by the Portland Pilots. Good help defense, Lowell. And that's all, you know, that's Wyatt basically coming over, helping and causing the turnover.
That is great team defense right there. 17 turnovers right now for New Orleans.
They average 19 a game. And they force a lot of turnovers, but the Pilots, you know, have done a pretty good job of taking care of the rock.
Only 11 turnovers on the night, and really have had a couple here as of late. So for the majority of the game, doing a good job. However, they have not had a field goal in almost 3.5 minutes.
Mid-range jumper, rimming off. And here comes Murphy Jr.
Good defense.
Vucinic basically just standing tall, would not be, you know, kind of knocked off his block.
Good sweep and go from the big guy. Big V with a move to the rim.
Omar Henry.
So Henry in foul trouble. Without a doubt, he's got four personals. Ten team fouls on UNO. Vucinic on the line. Vucinic. One of four in double figures for the Portland Pilots, led by Wood. 16 points and all those triples, those coming in the first half.
Yeah, Vucinic with 13 points right now, and 7 rebounds, and if you get that kind of effort out of him day in and day out, you're going to be really happy as a pilot.
Vucinic's career high is 18 points against Lewis and Clark earlier, so he's knocking on the door of that.
Oh, that was halfway down.
It sure was.
No field goals for New Orleans for 3 minutes, 15 seconds.
Lowell was handcuffed on his way to the rim.
You know, and honestly, like, New Orleans has to respect the 3-point threat because of the first half. And right now, Portland's just having their way to the rim and getting to the free throw line every time down.
Doughty with his second. Lowell to the free throw line. 0 for 1 from the charity stripe going into this effort. Lowell averages about 4.5 points a game. He's nearing that.
His minutes have extended here in the last few weeks, and you know, he had that great shooting performance against Multnomah. I just think it gave him a little bit of confidence, and you know, we'll see what happens here with the different rotations.
Jackson. Another board. Big V nearing a double-double. 12 and 7. Boy, you gotta like that. You know, Portland made a living from beyond the arc in the first half. More traditional hoops, if you will, this second half. Show some versatility.
Absolutely. And I like that. I like the effort coming off the staggered here, but I like the fact that they've done something different, not just lived and died.
6-0 pilot run. Program record 13 triples in the first half. That opens up the big lead, and then the Pilots settle in to some good old-fashioned basketball this second half.
Well, and quality looks, like we talked about. They did not force the issue. They were quality, on balance, good looks, and guys that can really shoot it. And there's a deep one right there.
Boy, no kidding. Scholin from way, way, way downtown. 14 now for Christian. One over his seasonal average.
Oh, good contest.
Yeah, it really was, but an even better finish.
Yeah.
My goodness. Chica back on the floor for the Pilots. Wood has 16, Scholin with 14. Robertson, Vucinic, 13 apiece.
Yeah, you got 4 guys and double figures.
And T-Rob is back on the floor, fresh off that layup that put him at 1,000 points. Quick flip isn't there. Cooper. Off balance and scores. Nice finish by Cooper. 10 points now for him.
Oh!
Ooh. Whoa!
Oh my goodness. He went up, put that in his left hand.
Wow!
Again, that's just that extra elevation.
Goodness! Wow!
Take a look at this.
Oh, so close as Jackson picks up his fourth. So Jackson will take a seat. He's got 10 points to go along with Cooper's 10 points. And Marquez is having a heck of a game for New Orleans. He's at his career 1 D high and then some is Cooper. So well done, young man. Fifteen points now for Scholin. Under 8 to go. Step back, tough shot, ball's loose, Chica comes up with it, throws a few bows, and here comes Wanze.
Good ball swings.
T-Rob unselfish, Chica. Gorosito, you bet! That's really good ball movement by the Pilots.
Just absolutely sweet. Extra pass, unselfish.
Gorosito now with 10.
And
the offensive, yes.
Yeah, he got clipped coming off trying to defend that.
Foul's gonna go against Turk Vincent. Sweet looking stroke from Christian. Extra pass, you know it. Wanze. Yep.
Portland just hammering the visiting Privateers. There are so many positives. You know, you look at Wanze, Gorosito perfect from the field. J-Mo, the last six from beyond the arc, Gorosito is 14 for 26. Well, that is bringing it.
It is, and it's the quality of shot again that he's taking. He's not forcing it. I thought in the, you know, first few games you get a little excited, get yourself going, and he's going to be something special down the road here. Coach Legs loves his potential.
Man, how could you not,
right? I mean, just perfect execution.
T-Rob with another assist. He's got 12. That ties his career high. Woods got 16 points, make it 19.
Oh, nice take.
Preston Murphy Jr.
Nice little reverse.
Wood had 21 against North Carolina, so he's nearing his season high. Career high for Moses Wood is 28. And this game will continue to slog along with more free throws.
Well, he was 4 of 4 from the three-point line to start the game. 5 of 7 on the night.
So, as of this moment, Portland has been absolutely scalding from beyond the arc, 17 for 29. They had 17 earlier against Multnomah in the season. And one more will set a school record for made triples for the Pilots. And they're not looking at the scoreboard, J-Mo. If they're open, they're going to shoot it.
Oh, absolutely. 59% from the three-point line. Just tremendous.
Season high in terms of three-point shooting for the Pilots.
I think Naduka's going to get caught with one here.
Yep,
His first. Jackson rimming off. Jackson's got the 10 points. Right about at his seasonal average, but just not that kind of dominant game. Chica, another assist for Robertson. That is a career high, and Chica cans the mid-range.
That's Chica's game right there.
Wild shot.
Ooh. And he just got hit hard.
Wow.
Jackson off the ball. Posted up really hard and just drilled him.
He will foul out of the game, Will Tyson Jackson.
Darius Washington, replacing Tyson Jackson.
13 assists now for T-Rob. That ties the D1 program record for Portland. We'll make sure of that, but he has been amazing. First miss of the game for Gorosito.
I honestly think he'll like that assist number more than anything.
I agree. He did hit that 1,000 career mark just moments ago, but I agree. The assists, man, he's just gonna think, I had to get my guys involved, and he did just that. .520 left to go in a game dominated by the Portland Pilots. A massive run in that first half gave the Pilots separation, and they have never looked back.
Well, just a collective effort by everybody. Everybody's contributed one way or another.
Mike Meadows, who has been sitting after re-injuring the groin, is the only guy who's played that hasn't scored for the Pilots. Chica, offensive board, wanting to go up strong. Nothing called, will go the other way. Robertson picks up his third. More free throws for UNO as Applewhite checks back in. What'd you learn about the Pilots tonight, J-Mo?
I like their grit. I love their character. You know, I think they really had a great week at that PK and coming off that high. You know, you still, they play at a very high level. And then kind of a reality check, losing that game the other night. But their response has been terrific. And I think it's really going to help them down the road.
Up next for the Pilots, Oregon in Eugene.
That'll be a big game for them.
Huge. And then one more non-con for the Pilots against Riverside before they host LMU in the conference opener December 29th. Step back, Gorosito. Started so hot, missed his last three.
Portland 0 of 5 from the field last few minutes here. Oh, that's got to be a travel.
Yeah, unfortunate for Washington. So with just under 4 to play, following UNO's 20th turnover, we'll take a quick break. Pilots cruising, 92-56. We're heading down the stretch, but this game is going to go on the win column. a player of the game, huh, Legs? You've got guys going off, milestones, career highs, this and that. What a team effort by the Pilots.
Oh, yes. Five guys in double figures. 25 points off of 20 turnovers.
Wow. When you make your opponent pay for their mistakes, when you punish them for turnovers, you're going to win a lot of ball games.
Well, and unselfish, 24 assists off 30 field goals. That is a great number.
28 is a season high in terms of helpers for the Pilots. That came against Multnomah. Applewhite shucks off the defender. 3:30 left to go in this ball game. This game well in hand for the Pilots, who will go to 8-5 on the season with Oregon next. Boise State awaits UNO.
And there's another turnover. 21 on the night.
Wow.
Just to be able to gather that and finish on the reverse.
So T-Rob with another assist. It's the D1 assist record at 14. Unbelievable. So the D1 UP record in assists, it belongs to T-Rob at 14 to go along with his milestone mark of 1,000 career points.
That's a pretty good night.
Goracito, hand in his face. Goracito in double figures. He's got the 13. One off of his career best, the youngster, showing us the dynamic flair as Henry cans it. So we'll take another quick break. Record-setting performances all over the place. T-Rob doing his thing. Lead is huge, 97-59. Moments left in this game. There's an exhausted T-Rob. Yeah, he hits 1,000 points, but how about the 15 assists? That is a new single-game assist mark at the University of Portland, and it breaks a record from a long time ago.
Yeah, and honestly, I think he's going to be more impressed with that or more pleased with that number than the actual scoring. It's just the kind of guy that he is.
Previous record, 1995. Deion Holton, and that is broken by T-Rob tonight. 15 helpers, a new single game record for the University of Portland to go along with charter membership in the 1,000 point club.
Charter membership.
Buck 56 left to go in this game. Wood leading everyone with the 21 points, including five triples, which is his season high and ties a career high. And Big V having himself a heck of a night, 14-8 right now.
Yeah, and I love to see that, because that's exactly what Portland needs, is an inside presence. And he's just establishing himself as the guy that they're going to go to right now.
Another cold spell by UNO, but this game well in hand for the Pilots.
Ooh.
Oh, boy. This game has been physical and really slow to get up as Moses Wood.
I think he got hit in the eye, kind of in the eye socket.
Bumped heads. You can see how red it is around his left eye. Wow.
Yeah, Wood. Inadvertent. You can see just kind of going after the loose ball here.
Oh,
yeah.
Boy.
It's right on the eye socket.
Timeout, a 30-second timeout. All right, so a minute 17 left to go in this game. The Pilots scored 98 points against Portland State, scored 100 against Multnomah. But when you factor in what a poor performance the Pilots showed us the other night against North Dakota State, you know, you hear the word bounce back and you can put that all in capital letters.
Big time. I mean, just a bounce back effort in all areas. Defensively, they picked it up on the rebounding category maybe halfway through the first half. And I mean, my goodness, just individual performances and guys off the bench contributing.
Yep. Everybody scoring tonight, except for Mike Meadows. Four of the five starters in double figures, led by Wood with the 21, T-Rob with the double-double in points and assists.
Balls out of bounds, present. Less than 1 minute. Less than 1 minute.
Tag team defense there on the trap.
Well, I think Moses has a pretty big goose egg.
Yeah, he's going to be feeling that pretty hoop
yeah,
there at the cup.
Yeah, you can see it right now.
Preston Murphy Jr. Timeout. New Orleans.
New Orleans calling a timeout with 39.1 left. J-Mo. Coach Legs told us that the preseason is going to show him a lot where they are, the Pilots, where they need to be, and how important it was for them to handle their business. And tonight, you know, they did just that.
Well, you're exactly right. And, you know, you want to schedule in the preseason to get yourself ready for conference. They've had a tough non-conference schedule. The other night was one that, you know, I don't think anybody expected, especially the way they played. But the effort that they've had tonight, the response, I mean, you can see the pieces are there. They've got a lot of people that can contribute. His rotation's going to get a little bit tighter, I would say, going into conference. He's got a couple more games to kind of play with some things. But, you know, I think there's some really, you know, bright spots with a lot of guys coming off the bench that have in the last couple weeks been really productive. And he's got to be pleased with that.
the depth that you covet as a coach, and you know this, coaching at the D1 level, when you can rest some of your guys when they need that rest and not dip in quality of play.
Well, that's the whole point. If you bring your bench in, you don't want to have, oh, they started the clock a little bit early. You don't want to have that dip. You want to stay solid. And that's what they've done tonight. I mean, they've got guys that have come in, and when they were shooting the ball well from the three-point line, the bench came in and did the same darn thing.
It'll be interesting to see what the extent of Mike Meadows' injury is. You know, he sat the entire second half. That could be the only downer of today.
Yeah, I'm hoping that was, again, more of a precautionary, just to make sure that he's okay.
Do it again. Why not? Sholin with an emphatic slam. Crowd digging tonight. Still fouling.
Well, coach said no shot, and now they're going to send him to the free throw line.
A chance for the Pilots to set a season high in terms of points. They dropped 100 on Multnomah.
Just Christian getting to the baseline, elevating, and he's very explosive.
I guess it's the most points New Orleans has given up all season. So Applewhite, usually pretty steady at the free throw line, misses the first one, misses the second. We're hoping that there is not another foul, and there's not. The final 100-61. We didn't expect this kind of a drubbing.
I did not expect this. I feel like this team is, New Orleans is much better than what they displayed tonight. But I just, again, the bounce back performance, and you get somebody hungry after the other night, their performance as a group. They came out, responded, scored the ball really well, and defended. Didn't turn it over too much, and just a great collective team effort.
You look at how everybody got into the act, scoring, playing the defense, the hustle plays, all the stuff that is a trademark of Ashante Leggins' team.
Well, and you know, you talked to Coach Leggs the other day. He said, we finally got a couple days of practice, and that makes a big difference, kind of getting back to the basics, getting back to fundamentals, talking about your core, working on little tiny things that make a big difference, and it paid off tonight.
Ice pack on the eye of Moses Wood. He conked heads with the privateer. We'll hope that that goose egg goes down and then see what the extent of Mike Meadows' injury is. But all in all, a terrific team win for the Portland Pilots.
You're absolutely right. Yeah, that's a nice little goose egg that he's got going there.
So as we mentioned, up next for the Pilots, they will be in Eugene December 17th. That is going to be one heck of a test.
Well, what's good, too, is these guys are going to get some practice reps like we talked about. You know, getting a week of practice, get a couple days off. You take a look at the stats here. 55% from the field. Did a good job on the boards. 27 assists on 33 field goals and only 13 turnovers in that game. That's a great effort of taking care of the ball and being efficient.
27 assists. That is just awesome. One off of a season high. T-Rob, can you hear us?
I can.
All right, young man. We're dying to know. Here's the question of the hour. You ready?
Yep.
Okay. What means more to you? Hitting 1,000 points or those 15 assists setting a new single-game record here at the University of Portland?
I'd say a bit of both, but I'm just excited we got a home win. We had a bad loss last week that we all felt pretty disappointed about. We felt like we should have won that game. We're really disappointed in our efforts, so I was just glad our team bounced back. Obviously, there's some personal accolades that are cool to hit, but I'm just glad that we got a big-time home win in front of a good crowd.
I was sure you were going to say assist. But what was the message the last couple days in practice? You guys got a chance to kind of go back and work on some things after that loss the other night. Not a typical performance from you guys to get to the point where you are tonight with the response.
I think we just had to come in and compete every single day. A big emphasis was just making sure that we went at each other. Obviously, some of the best competition we'll play this season is against each other. And so just coming in each and every day to practice, working hard, playing together, having fun. It's just big for our team and a big stepping stone with a big two games to finish off this preseason.
What do you think the difference has been? I mean, you look at all the guys that contributed tonight. You have bench play. You have guys that can rest their legs a little bit. What has that meant to the squad?
It's been big time, and that's a credit to our coaching staff, obviously bringing in some big-time recruits. And obviously those guys just coming in and playing with freedom. Our starting five is a solid group, but we're nothing without our bench coming in. And I'm just proud of those guys coming in, playing their role, doing everything they can to help us get this home win.
All right, congrats on hitting 1,000, pal, and congrats on the new assist record here at the University of Portland. Well done.
Thank you very much. Go Pilots.
Gotta love that guy. All right. Heck of a win for the Portland Pilots, J-Mo. And as he said, it's a team deal, and they showed it tonight.
And that's just the kind of guy he is. Yep. Right there. I mean, it's all about the team, and that's why you love him, and that's why Legs thinks so highly of him, and he's going to do great things.
All right. Here's the schedule. Oregon Riverside, and then here we go.
LMU and BYU to open conference play. You know, it doesn't get any easier, but I thought they had a great response tonight, and they got a big week of practice coming up.
All right, that's going to do it from the Bluff. Portland drills New Orleans, the final 100-61. Huge bounce back win for the Pilots. For J-Mo and everyone on our broadcast crew, I'm Ann saying so long from the Child Center. Thanks for watching Pilots Hoops with us. Enjoy the rest of your weekend.